Hey guys, yet another short debunking for a common conspiracy theorist talking point that seems to appear below almost every 9/11 topic on Reddit or Twitter. This one, however, is particularly egregious, as whoever chopped this footage up knew they were being dishonest, as they cut key parts of the interview out, which tells a very different story to what they left in. In the edited version, which is claimed to have only ever aired once and never again, despite CNN's full 9/11 coverage being easily found online for almost 2 decades now, Jamie McIntyre tells Judy he walked right up close to the building. The interview then cuts to Jamie saying, "From my close-up inspection, there's no evidence of a plane having crashed anywhere near the Pentagon. The only site is the side of the building that's crashed in." He then goes on to say, "The only pieces are small enough to pick up with your hand. There are no large tail sections, wing sections, fuselage, anywhere around." The video then abruptly cuts. Let's have a look.
Outside the Pentagon, CNN's military affairs correspondent Jamie McIntyre. And Jamie, you got very close to where that plane went down.
That's right, Judy. A while ago, I walked right up to next to the building where firefighters were still trying to put out the blaze. The fire, by the way, is still burning in some parts of the Pentagon. And I took a look at the huge gaping hole that's in this sideway, but from my close-up inspection, there's no evidence of a plane having crashed anywhere near the Pentagon. The only site is the actual side of the building that's crashed in, and as I said, the only pieces left that you can see are small enough that you could pick up in your hand. There are no large tail sections, wing sections, a fuselage, nothing like that anywhere.
Now, I didn't edit that. That's literally how abrupt that video cuts and finishes. So what was cut that's so important? There's 2 key parts of this interview missing. The first is where Jamie describes after walking up close to the Pentagon all the aircraft debris that he witnessed scattered all over the front of the Pentagon. The second is where Judy Woodruff asked Jamie about reports from an earlier eyewitness who said that they thought they saw the aircraft crash short of the Pentagon. To which Jamie then accurately replies that there is no evidence of an airliner crashing anywhere near the Pentagon. The only crash site is the side of the Pentagon itself. Here's the interview with the parts that's been left out. Now, I've also edited this to remove some stuff that isn't really applicable. However, the full unedited interview is uploaded on my channel and is linked in the description so that you can view it yourself in its entirety.
Outside the Pentagon, CNN's military affairs correspondent Jamie McIntyre. And Jamie, you got very close to where that plane went down.
That's right, Judy. A while ago, I walked right up to next to the building and I took a look at the huge gaping hole that's in this side of the Pentagon. I could see parts of the airplane that crashed into the building, very small pieces of the plane on the heliport outside the building. The biggest piece I saw was about 3 feet long. It was silver and had been painted green and red, but I could not see any identifying markings on the plane. I also saw a large piece of shattered glass. It appeared to be a cockpit windshield or other window from the plane.
Jamie, Aaron was talking earlier, one of our correspondents was talking earlier, I think it was Bob Franken, with an eyewitness who said it appeared that that Boeing 757, the American Airlines jet, landed short of the Pentagon. Can you give us any better idea of how much of the plane actually impacted the building?
You know, it might have appeared that way, but from my close-up inspection, there's no evidence of a plane having crashed anywhere near the Pentagon. The only site is the actual side of the building that's crashed in, and as I said, the only pieces left that you can see are small enough that you could pick up in your hand. There are no large tail sections, wing sections, a fuselage, nothing like that anywhere around, which would indicate that the entire plane crashed into the side of the Pentagon and then caused the side to collapse.
So it's pretty clear watching the full interview that not only did Jamie see aircraft debris in front of the Pentagon, but more importantly, that his statement that there is no evidence of a plane having crashed anywhere near the Pentagon was in direct response to a question from Judy asking if an airliner had crashed short of the Pentagon instead of into the Pentagon. Jamie himself clarifies this also. In an interview a couple of years ago, he states, "I was describing the plane crash to the anchor, Judy Woodruff. I was describing the scene. I was describing how I'd been up to the side of the Pentagon and seen parts of the plane. Most of them were very small, so small you could pick them up and hold them in your hand. And she said to me, Jamie, what about reports we had earlier from an eyewitness, one of her own reporters, that a plane had crashed near the Pentagon, short of the Pentagon? And I said, Judy, I can tell you from my close-up inspection, meaning that I've been up to the scene to see the plane crash, there's no sign of a plane having crashed anywhere near the Pentagon. The only crash site is the part of the building behind me that's all caved in. The context was essentially that she was asking me whether a plane had crashed some distance from the Pentagon, and I was saying, no, the only plane that crashed was the one that hit the Pentagon. That was one of many, many things and events that were taken out of context that day by people who are just predisposed to believe the official story is not true, and they are looking for any reason not to believe it. I'll link that full interview in the description below as well. Once again, it must be pointed out that the people who cut this interview up knew exactly the content and the context that they were leaving out. Once again, proving that conspiracy theorists are some of the most dishonest people on the planet, and that those who fall for this garbage only do so because they're too biased and lazy to seek out the original footage themselves to check the accuracy of the claims. And they call us the sheep. Thanks for watching, guys.